In this illustration, we'll study about the radial force on a ring inside a solenoid. We are given that a thin wire ring of radius A and resistance R is placed coaxially inside a long solenoid of length L and cross-sectional radius B. And we are given that at t equal to 0, solenoid is connected to a battery of EMF V. If total circuit resistance is R, we are required to find the maximum radial magnetic force per unit length acting on the ring wire. Here, we can directly write as the solenoid is connected to a circuit of resistance R and EMF V. We can write the growing current in solenoid is, this can be given as V by R, 1 minus e to power minus RT by L, where we can also write the value of L, that is a coefficient of self-induction for the solenoid, which can be given as mu naught N square A by L, if N are the total number of turns, A is its area and L is the length of solenoid. Here we can substitute it as mu naught. The value of N can be written as small n L whole square if small n are number of turns per unit length. Area here we can write as pi B square divided by L, which will give us mu naught N square pi B square L. This is the value of coefficient of self-inductance of the solenoid we'll use later. And here if this is the current in solenoid, we can calculate the flux linked with the ring in solenoid is. This flux we can write as, due to this current, the magnetic induction will be mu naught Ni multiplied by pi A square, that is the cross-sectional area of the ring. If we substitute the value of this current over here, this will be mu naught N pi A square V by R multiplied by 1 minus e to power minus RT by L. If this is the flux differentiating, this will give us the EMF induced in the ring. So we can calculate the EMF induced in ring. This can be written as mod of d phi by dt, which on differentiating will give us mu naught N pi A square V by R multiplied by R by L multiplied by e to power minus RT by L. Here R also gets cancelled out. If this is the EMF, we are given that the resistance of this ring is R, so we can also get the current induced in ring as I is equals to E by R. So this will be mu naught N pi A square V divided by R L e to power minus RT by L. So if this is the current induced in the ring, which can be written as I R, the current in the ring. And if this is the current in ring, it is placed in the magnetic field B of the solenoid, which is mu naught Ni. So we can calculate the magnetic radial force on ring wire per unit length as this force we can write as BIL. So this will be B multiplied by current in the coil as IR and length we take as unity. So the value in this situation is, this can be given as, we substitute the value of IR over here and B as mu naught Ni. This will be mu naught Ni, that is the magnetic induction in the solenoid multiplied by the ring current, which is mu naught N pi A square V by RL multiplied by e to power minus RT by L. So this is the value of magnetic force per unit length acting on the ring, and the value of current also we can substitute from here, that is the current flowing in the solenoid. So value of force we are getting is, this can be written as mu naught square n square pi a square v by, this will be r r l, this v also become a square, this e to power minus rt by l multiplied by 1 minus e to power minus rt by l. This is the force we are getting, and we are required to find the maximum radial magnetic force. So this is the force per unit length, radial force per unit length on the ring. So here we can write F is maximum when df over dt. In this situation here you can see this factor is varying. So in this situation we can write this will be maximum when df by dt is equals to 0. If we differentiate this expression, these all terms are constants. So on differentiating this, we are getting it as minus r by l e to power minus rt by l plus 2r by l e to power minus 2rt by l is equals to 0. Further simplifying this, we are getting twice of e to power minus rt by l is equals to 1. So this is giving us e to power minus rt by l is equals to 1 by 2. That means when this factor e to power minus rt by l becomes half, the value of force will be maximum. Here you can further verify that second derivative of this expression at e to power minus rt by equals to half will be a negative value that verifies that the force will be maximum. So here we can write the maximum value of force will be equals to, here if we substitute the values, this mu naught square n square pi a square v square divided by rrl, and this will be 1 by 2 multiplied by 1 by 2. So this will be 4 rrl. And here we can further substitute the value of coefficient of self-induction from this value. If we substitute it here, 1 mu naught gets cancelled out, and this will be mu naught n square pi gets cancelled out. So this will be a square v square divided by, and the value here will be 4 r r, and the remaining values are l b square. So this is the final answer for this problem, the maximum radial force per unit length acting on this wire ring, which is coaxially placed inside the solenoid.